trying to get that run. Sterling does not want him down there, but it didn't work.
Jeff Gordon to the lead in Indianapolis. The fans are going crazy. Hometown hero takes the point.
Jeff knows the best chance he's got is to put as much distance between him and those guys. He's got four fresh tires right now, so he's going to get it.
For a guy who went nowhere in the early part of this race, would you believe in the final laps, Gordon finds himself racing for the win. It'll be the white flag as Gordon comes off of turn four and down the front straightaway.
Once again, going right up against an outside retaining wall.
Final lap of the Brickyard 400 is underway. Jeff Gordon out in front of Sterling Marlin by 1 second. He celebrated his 30th birthday here yesterday with family and friends around him. Celebrated with a rather subpar qualifying run that put him back 27th on the starting grid. The car not very good in the opening part of the race. The crew kept working, got the strategy right, got the chassis right, and now Jeff Gordon is one corner away from a Brickyard 400 win. Three straight years, the winner of this race has gone on to be the NASCAR Winston Cup Series champion. Jeff Gordon, the point leader, comes off the corner and becomes a three-time winner of the Brickyard 400 at Indianapolis. It looked like he didn't have a chance to win, and he winds up going to the winner's circle to hold the big trophy.
I'm amazed.
And the celebration begins down here on Pitt Road as Robbie Loomis wins the biggest race of your career. Robbie, you told me you dreamed of someday winning here. Does now reality match that dream?
Yeah, I tell you, it's really special. You know, we started so bad today, and this pit crew, the guys on this team, they just work, they work, they work. You know, we had a great engine today. Rick Kendrick supplies us with the great stuff to work with. Put Jeff Gordon on top of it, let him fight all day long, you get a result like this. I mean, you get in the situation, you start a race as bad as we did today, you guys saw it, and, you know, it's really great to be sitting here. We got to count our blessings. I'd like to thank the good Lord, because I was praying a lot there at the end, and really worked out well. This team's the greatest race team, and that driver's unbelievable.
A special and emotional win for Robbie Loomis in the 24 team. Loomis prepared the car that Rick Kendrick won his 100th career win as a car owner in Michigan. This same car wins at Indy.
Alan, thumbs up from Jeff Gordon on his 56th career NASCAR Winston Cup Series victory. The winner's trophy for the Brickyard 400 inscribed with each victor's name. Jeff Gordon's on there twice already, and the blank panel awaiting the third inscription after his victory today. But Jeff Gordon came around to the start-finish line trying to celebrate with the crowd and do a little burnout.
Jeff, you've got to hold your foot on the brake when you do it. That's how Harvick gets away with it, man.
I was listening to his radio channel. He came on the radio about here and said, I can't do it.
That might be the first time he has tried to do a burnout.
Oh, terrific.
From the hometown Indianapolis fans,
Jeff Gordon in victory lane at Indianapolis.
Brooke, car owner Rick Kendrick.
And a worn out Jeff Gordon.
How's it feel to be 30?
Woo! Oh, I think I got a few new gray hairs after today. Wow, what an incredible day. I never dreamed it. You know, at the beginning we were way off. I think most of it's just being in traffic more so than the car being off. And, you know, here lately we hadn't had too many pit strategy things go for us, but today that was the key. We had one caution follower way early, and then whether we took two or gas and go there at the end, and we took two, and it was absolutely the perfect thing to do. Car drove great once I got out front.
Who made that decision, Jeff?
Well, you know, Robbie makes all the calls. I mean, he, talks to other guys on the team. He knows what's going on. He talks to me. We make it together. And, you know, we were between no tires and two tires, and I mean, I thought that we needed two, you know, and we needed some tires. If it was just one, you know, we needed it. But I just want to thank God. This has just been such an amazing week for me. Yeah, this is the best way to celebrate my birthday, and I just thank him for everything. But
told us you don't race for records, you race for wins, but you're the first three-time winner of the Brickyard 400 at the Indianapolis Motor Speedway, your track.
Thank you, Bill. It feels unbelievable. I mean, to have all these people still here cheering us on, I got choked up in the car. You know, it feels amazing. I love Indianapolis. I love the state of Indiana. It's been so good to me. And I want to say hi to all the folks out in Pittsburgh. I know they're excited and going to be celebrating tonight. But, you know, I don't know. Sometimes things just work in your favor, you know, and certainly today all the right things did. I didn't think we had the car to do it. But Robbie Loomis, Brian Watch, all the guys in this DuPont Chevrolet team, they did a phenomenal job today.
Congratulations.
Thank you very much. And, I don't race for statistics. I race to win. And if we win, then the statistics will come after that. And that's what happened today. Three Brickyard 400.
Woo! Absolutely. Jeff Gordon is back home in victory lane, Alan.
Fourth win of the season for Jeff Gordon.
Jeff Gordon has gotten by Jeff Burton. He's out in front with 12 laps to go. What an exchange it was. Burton did not want to give up. Let's go back and take a look at it.
It all starts. We go down by the start-finish line. Jeff Gordon dives to the inside. Has position on Jeff Burton. Has the lead, right? Wrong. Look at Burton. Turn that car right and get alongside Jeff Gordon. There you go, up through the S's. Jeff Gordon had no... He had to back off. Now as they go through the S's up the backstretch, Jeff Gordon gets a tremendous run on Jeff Burton. Too many Jeffs in this race. Gets position going on the inner loop. Takes the lead.
Jeff wants the 21 down by the chicane. He's wounded bad.
But once the caution comes out, after the white flag is displayed, you race back around to it. So we're still at full speed. Oh, that's Elliott Sadler crab walking through the inner loop.
He's made some serious contact with the wall someplace. Is he going to be in the way of the leaders as they come by and racing back to the start-finish line?
And did he drop any oil? Burton trying to stay with Gordon. Final straightaway. Look at Elliott Sadler's car. Rear end must be broken out of it.
Wow, Burton is really close gap.
Race for third behind the leaders. Rudd trying to get Mayfield. But here comes the road course king, Jeff Gordon. Second win in a row, and he takes his seventh road course victory. Winning here at Watkins Glen. Burton second, Mayfield held off Rudd for third. Ricky was fourth, Todd Bodine fifth. Fourth win in the last five tries here at Watkins Glen for Jeff Gordon. Came into the race with a 160-point lead in the NASCAR Winston Cup Championship. Gordon wins, Rudd finishes fourth, and Dale Jarrett is going to finish back 31st or 32nd, pending the final scoring. Matt?
High fives and a hug from Rick Hendrick. I thought we were going to have to shake you there, Robbie Loomis, over the past two laps. We didn't see you moving up there. How nervous were you?
Whew, I'll tell you what, this competition's gotten tougher and tougher. Thanks, Todd. And, you know, Jeff just did a great job. You saw the pass he made there with Burton. I mean, that was two men going at it clean as can be. And can't say enough about Brian White or the guys on this team. I mean, they just worked so hard time after time after time. You know, it's just great to be here in victory lane with Hendrick Motorsports.
Can you describe how special it is to be a part of history 2 weeks in a row?
I tell you, well, we're just trying to win races. You know, that's what we're trying to do. The history, that part's great. But you got a driver like Jeff Gordon. We just got to make sure we do our part. Everyone at Hendrick Motorsports, the DuPont Chevrolet, is doing a great job.
Jeff Gordon, his Rainbow Warriors, back on track on the road courses after a 23rd and a third place finish. The 24 car is headed back to victory lane.
Fifth win of the season for Jeff Gordon.
Come on, buddy, come on.
There you go, hey. Jeff Gordon. That's the way to do it.
He's learning.
See, he thought he'd do it over the backstretch where no one could see him.
He's got it down now.
Oh, yeah.
Attaboy, Jeff.
Jeff, Kevin Harvick and Jeff Gordon are on the same radio show Monday night, my radio show, and Kevin told him how to do it. He said, you got
I told him how to do it last week.
But now, Jeff Gordon climbs out on familiar ground, Victory Lane at Watkins Glen for the Rainbow Warrior, the Road Course King. A kiss from his wife, Brooke. Car owner Rick Hendrick is here. Robbie Loomis will step in as well. This win at Indianapolis a week ago really inspired this team. 160 points the lead coming in here, the biggest this season. Great race and excellent burnout.
Thank you. I had to redeem myself. Yeah, that was a burnout there. When you get these guys some confidence in them, just watch out, you know, and they give me confidence in my driving. And I knew we had a great race car yesterday, but I kept getting, you know, great restarts on that one time when he was in front of us. Thought I was going to lose it all right there because I tried to make a run on Ricky Rudd, about got by me, did get by me, and he got loose up in the S's, and we just fought hard, you know. There's a lot of desire out there, and I just thank God for the perseverance and the strength to go out there and do this as a team like we did.
And here comes Mark Martin. He's making a bid for the lead. He's alongside Ricky Rudd, and here's Jeff Gordon right behind him.
It'll be the first time all day Martin's led if he can hold it to the start-finish line. Here comes Gordon.
Down on the apron of the speedway. He's alongside Mark going down to one.
Outside clear, all clear.
Gordon's lead has stabilized over Newman, it appears.
Ryan Newman might be guilty right now of driving just a little bit too hard. And who can blame him?
The white flag is up. Final lap here at Kansas
flag
City.
Flag lap, clear by four, clear by five.
Five car lengths. Gordon Spotter telling him he's clear on Ryan Newman. Rusty Wallace trying to challenge Ricky Rudd for third spot behind these two. Inaugural races have been very, very good for Jeff Gordon. He won at Indianapolis in the first race there. He won at California the first race there. Here he comes to the checkered flag. Gordon wins at Kansas City. Ryan Newman gets second. Ricky Rudd barely holds off Rusty Wallace. Sixth time in 2001, Jeff Gordon is your winner. He led 53 laps today, five different times out in front. Took the lead for the final time at lap 246 of 267. And held off a very determined youngster to get his victory.
Finished second to Jeff Gordon. You know, there's many other champions out here, but he's a great one.
Hey, just watch how he's doing there out in the grass, making those donuts. You'll know how to do it when you finally pull off that victory.
Big coffee on that, but just a good day for the Alltel crew, and you know, good to have two Penske cars in the top five. Just a great run for us overall.
Congratulations, Ryan.
Look at the skid marks from Jeff Gordon all the way through the grass. Came off the pit lane and just threw it out into the tri-oval.
Probably had a little emotional motivation this morning. His special guest at the driver's meeting was Matt Dahl, the son of United Airlines pilot Jason Dahl, who was aboard United Flight 93 that crashed in Pennsylvania. A kiss from his wife, Brooke, some high fives, a fist pump, and he will celebrate in the confetti-filled Victory Lane. Handshakes all around. Congratulations. Welcome to Kansas.
Oh, I'm glad to be here. Can't wait to come back. Man, what an awesome day for the DuPont Chevrolet team. You know, we had a good car, top two or three all day long. I hate it for Rusty. That was a tough break for him, and, you know, he had the car to beat. I think we had something for him there, though. we hung right onto his bumper that one time. If we could have got out in front of him, I think we had something for him. But, whew, what a great day. Just want to thank God for all the adversity this team has come through over the last, heck, year and a half. And we made it here, man. Wish you were here. We'll see you in Charlotte.
Congratulations to Jeff Gordon, the first winner here at Kansas Speedway, Alan.
All right, Phil, thank you. In the end, Jeff Gordon enjoyed his trip to Kansas City the most. He's won the inaugural Protection 1 400. For Wally Dallenbeck, Benny Parsons, Bill Weber, and our entire NASCAR on NBC crew, Alan Bestwick, so long from Kansas City, now off to the Gravity Games.
Gordon was letting his tires come in. Now that they have come in, he's moving to the front.
There's another guy moving to the front.
And BP, that high line, especially in one and two, looks like it's the fastest way around here, which usually down low is better.
Jeff Gordon passed Tony Stewart for second during the commercial break a moment ago. Here he comes for the lead.
Ooh. Oh, ho, ho. I think Junior thought about using that high line, but wisely decided not to do that, and Jeff Gordon goes to the front.
Just passed 50 miles, and Gordon puts himself to the point. Now, what that means for the championship is that now he just needs to finish 31st or better to wrap up the title today, because he's got the 5 bonus points for leading. Listening to Jeff Gordon's radio as we go through the field and check in on how some of the top runners are doing in the early going. Bill Weber.
Well, Alan, obviously you had Jeff Gordon doing very well. 24th to first. He called in a few minutes ago, said the car's pushing just a little bit. It was tight when he went back out. Gordon, 24th to the leader of the race, Marty.
Now there's a battle going on for the sixth position. Jared had it from Junior. Junior took it back away, and here comes Jeff Gordon trying to take it away from both of them.
One more lap, and Jeff Gordon clinches the championship, because then he couldn't finish far enough down in the race to lose the points he'd need to lose. So next time he crosses the start-finish line, Jeff Gordon is the 2001 NASCAR Winston Cup Series champion. And he's going to do it, fighting Dale Earnhardt Jr. for sixth place.
Oh,
a little loose there, BP.
A little loose. Todd got her down on the apron.
Let's listen. I guess he's a little busy for them to pass that message on to him right now.
Well, he moves into the sixth position. But he's got about 2 seconds to the next spot.
Well, he wanted to win it running up front. It's not going to be a win, which earlier in the day looked like it had the potential to be. There's the banner. It's official now. NASCAR Winston Cup Series champions for 2001, Jeff Gordon and the Hendrick Motorsports team.
4 times he has won the championship. And he's, what, 30 years old? My goodness.
9 seasons, 4 championships. That's incredible. And he pretty much locked it up with a strong run of races middle of the season. Wins at Indianapolis and Watkins Glen in early August set him on the road to the championship. And now just a couple of more laps to go before the celebration can begin, and the champion's trophy is handed over to Jeff Gordon. Bobby Labonte wins the race, and Jeff Gordon has locked up the championship. Bobby Labonte, the defending NASCAR Winston Cup champion, will yield the trophy to Jeff Gordon today. And for Jeff Gordon, boy, what can you say? 4 championships in 9 seasons of Winston Cup racing. No one will feel anything but happiness for this man, Robbie Loomis. We talked about him last week in our pre-race show, and Dave, let's hear from the new champion crew chief.
And a big hug from the second place today anyway, up until that point, Fatback McSwain, the crew chief for Ricky Rudd. But you are the Winston Cup champion crew chief for 2001. How does that feel, Rob?
Phew, I'll tell you, it feels great. It's just, you know, this championship, I said all along, is Jeff Gordon's championship. People all along have really never, I think, give Jeff the credit he is. And I'm just fortunate to be a part of these guys. This DuPont race team, Hendrick Motorsports, all the guys at the shop, Brian Weitzel, the job he's done all year long. It's just a great team effort, and I can't say enough, it hasn't sunk in yet.
I think some folks might have doubted early in the season. Obviously, Las Vegas was the first win, but did you guys think you had it early on?
You know, we just come out and put our best foot forward each week, every practice, every qualifying effort, and every race. And like I said, we've been very blessed. The good Lord's been with us all the way. We've been doubted since all our life. I think everybody's been doubted, but that's part of life. We just got to put your best foot forward, and what you get is what you get. This was a great year for us.
A familiar place and a sight for Jeff Gordon. Another NASCAR Winston Cup championship, his fourth. One of only three men to win four or more championships. He knows the pose, and he knows the trophy. Tony Gibson and the rest of his crew all here. Be a few high fives. We're gonna run into next year's Daytona 500. A hug for Robbie Loomis, we knew that was coming. And now for car owner Rick Hendrick. Congratulations, champ.
Oh man, wow. I'm just blown away. I'm just absolutely blown away that this is our fourth time doing this. It seems like the first time all over again. Each one gets sweeter. And all the guys in the DuPont Chevrolet team, they just were incredible this year. You know, they just were flawless in the way they prepared these race cars, in the way they performed on pit road, the way the engines performed. That was a backup in there, and you would never known it today. Just really, I could be here all day long thanking everybody. I want to thank Robbie Loomis. It's his first championship. We're really proud to have him on board and get him his first championship, as well as a lot of other guys on this DuPont team. Brian Weitzel, there's so many guys that are crucial to this championship. And all year long, we've been honoring America and honoring heroes. And I think it's only fitting that we honor, I think, one of the greatest champions NASCAR will ever have is Dale Earnhardt.
I think they agree.
Well, he taught me how to race for a championship, and he taught me an awful lot of other things, but we miss him a lot, and we're just so proud to be able to get this Winston Cup championship and get our fourth one. And I know if he's here, he'd be the first one coming over here congratulating us. So
thanks to guys like Jeff Gordon and Rick Hendricks for making it that way. Jeff, on behalf of everyone at NASCAR, Bill France, his family, all the employees and members of NASCAR, the millions of fans, congratulations on joining an elite group. There's not many guys, it's won four of them. You're only one of three, so congratulations, and we're proud of you. Thank you a lot.
Thank you, Mike. Thank you.
And from the R.J. Reynolds Tobacco Company Chairman and CEO, Andy Schindler.
Jeff, I want to congratulate you, the 24 team, Rick Hendricks and Hendricks Motorsports, for winning the 2001 NASCAR Winston Cup Championship. This is your fourth championship, and I'm proud to say I've been here to present all four of them to you. Here's your trophy, man.
The 2001 NASCAR Winston Cup champion, Jeff Gordon, his fourth. These are moments you never forget.
No, I tell you, I want to thank Mike and everybody from NASCAR, and of course Andy and everybody from Winston. This has been an incredible year for us, and the sport has grown to a whole new level, and we're just so proud of all the efforts that were put out to take this sport to that level, and proud to be a part of it. But every time I hear that number four, four championships, it still just boggles my mind. I can't believe it. But I didn't do it alone. I did it with every member of this race team. They came together and said they wanted to be champions, and they proved it. And through the grace of God, we were able to do this together as a team and just get through a lot of adversity from last year and just build on that and become a much stronger team this year and come out here and win a championship. And phenomenal year.
Yeah, you cornered the market on adversity last year, didn't you?
Yeah, we were testing our patience quite often. But you know what? I keep saying, I've said all year long, that year we had last year is what made us champions this year. If you don't go through some tough times along the way, then you really never find out what exactly you're made of. And you know, you can say all day long that you're champions through the tough times and the good times, but until you go through and do it like that and come back and be champions. And there are a lot of critics that didn't think we could come back and do it, and it makes us awful proud to be able to come back and put this thing up front all year long and win races, big races, and then come here and do it in the fashion we did today with a good, strong finish.
Congratulations to you, your car owner, and your entire team. You're the 2001 NASCAR Winston Cup champion.
Thank you so much. It's awesome.
Woo! Jeff Gordon celebrates here at the Atlanta Motor Speedway his fourth championship. And, of course, they'll also give him a little bit of money here, Alan.
What do you say about Jeff Gordon? I'm sitting here looking at the stat sheet that they faxed over here from the press box. Let's see. At age 30, the youngest driver ever to score four championships. Fourth title in 9 years. Incredible what the young man and his race team have accomplished.
Really, they have been a phenomenal team. They felt, everyone said when Ray Evernham left, the team was gone down the tube. Robbie Loomis came in and they didn't have the success right away that everyone thought that Jeff Gordon should have. But he and Robbie Loomis finally got on the same page, and they are communicating beautifully, and they still have a terrific race team there.
And the weight of the world is off that team's shoulders. They wanted to get this thing done this weekend. They did not want to really race this championship going into New Hampshire next weekend. So great team, great effort. Jeff's a great champion. These guys deserved it.
Rick Hendrick, his fifth Winston Cup title. He's assembled just an outrageously impressive organization, but I think perhaps the man on the championship team everyone will feel most happy for is Robbie Loomis.
Yeah, but the end of this season has been so weird. I mean, because all of a sudden, the guys that were so strong at the first of the season aren't strong near the end. When we go to Loudon on Friday afternoon, who knows who's going to step up and be the main guy there?
A lot at stake at New Hampshire. All of the top 10 spots in the points except first will be up for grabs, and that's a lot of money between those positions. That's at noon Eastern time. This coming Friday, spend part of your Thanksgiving weekend with us. We'll be in what will hopefully be sunny New Hampshire for the New Hampshire 300. Jeff Gordon, your 2001 NASCAR Winston Cup Series champion. Great race here in Atlanta today, but in the end, turn the page in that record book. Jeff Gordon joins Dale Earnhardt and Richard Petty with a fourth Winston Cup title. That's all for today from Atlanta.
Jeff, thank you, buddy. You know, not only for the four championships, but everything you've done for Hendrick Motorsports and for the way you and Brooke have touched our lives. Your driving talent, it speaks for itself, but often one that people realize the enormous amount of time and energy you spend helping others. You never seek recognition. You are true champions in many, many ways. And this team is special. You are true warriors. 2 years ago, they lost a crew chief, the pit crew, the engine assembler, and the lead fabricator. Jeff, you and Brian Weitzel, who deserves to be up here tonight, stepped up, recruited Robbie, and began to rebuild. Tonight, we're celebrating one of the most profound comebacks in the sport. I can't say enough about Robbie as a person, a crew chief, and a leader. This team is very special because there are no egos and they have so much fun together. The credit for that goes to Robbie and Brian's leadership.
Thank you, Benny.
Woo!
It's great to be in New York City. I humbly stand before you tonight, not the works of my own, but with the help of many whom I'd like to thank. I have to keep it short, however, because Mr. Hendrick said we must get ready for Daytona. First of all, I need to thank God for giving me all the opportunities and making me stronger through failures along the way. The valuable lessons I've learned from each driver I've worked have made this a reality. The world's greatest drivers are in this room tonight. They motivate us each week. In the words of Vince Lombardi, this award is a result of a combined effort of you. Let's do it, guys. Papa Joe, you built the foundation for these championships. Rick and Linda Hendrick, congratulations. The tools and talented people you surround us with make it possible to achieve our dreams. 8 championships in 7 years speaks louder than words. John and Kathy, thanks for your friendship, kindness, and spiritual touch. Randy Dorton and Rick Wetzel, best engine program in Winston Cup. Hendrick Engineering Group, Rex, Gary, and Jim, Thanks most of all for not always agreeing with me. Ken House, thanks for your knowledge and wisdom. You're a true racer. Eddie Dickerson and everyone in the chassis shop, great cars, and I know, guys, great bodies. To all Hendrick Motorsports employees, I appreciate your hard work, and I hope you're having fun at the party back in Charlotte. Now the ones who pour their sweat and tears into the 24 DuPont race team. Your talent, hard work, leadership, and dedication are unprecedented. Together, we have accomplished great things. Brian Weitzel, four-time champion. Without you, none of this would have been possible tonight. Oh, and Mary, you're a great cook. Well, I guess we let the cat out of the bag. Now, everyone knows what I've long known. Jeff Gordon, you are one of the all-time greats. Jeff, you believed in us when at times it was hard to believe in ourselves. Your focus, determination, and unassuming nature helped to unite our team. Lord, let us not get caught up in our circumstances at hand. However, let us look forward to the opportunities that lie ahead. Thank you, God bless you, and happy holidays. Thank you, guys.
Hard driving consistency, our 2001 NASCAR Winston Cup Series champion led lap after lap, claiming his fourth series title in 7 years, joining Richard Petty and Dale Earnhardt as the only drivers in Winston Cup Series history to capture more than three championships. Gordon's quest for four began with the first of a series leading seven Bud Bowls at Rockingham. In March, Gordon and crew chief Robbie Loomis celebrated the first of six trips to Victory Lane by cashing in on a Winston No Bull 5 million-dollar bonus at Las Vegas. A hard-fought fourth at Bristol and a fifth at Texas set the stage for a remarkable streak of six top three finishes in seven starts, including consecutive runner-up finishes at California and Richmond. A complete team effort and a victory at the Winston led to successive wins at Dover Downs and Michigan in June, the latter of which represented NASCAR win number 100 for Hendrick Motorsports. Yet another Bud Pole effort at Sears Point and the resulting third place finish only reinforced Gordon's versatility behind the wheel. With wife Brooke looking on, the 1993 Raybestos Rookie of the Year sped to yet another Bud Pole at New Hampshire, yielding a second place finish. Convincing wins at Indianapolis and Watkins Glen in August set the DuPont Automotive Finishes Chevrolet team apart as the ones to beat for the 2001 championship. A runner-up finish at Darlington in September added to Gordon's series-leading total of 18 top five finishes. And with a victory at the Kansas inaugural, Gordon extended his point advantage entering the season's final stretch. Top 10 finishes at Martinsville, Talladega, Phoenix, and a title-clinching sixth-place drive at Atlanta sealed the deal for Gordon, Hendrick, Loomis, and the entire DuPont Automotive Finishes team. Jeff Gordon is now the youngest four-time Winston Cup Series champion in NASCAR history. Driving to a season-leading six wins, 18 top fives, and 24 top 10 finishes, please welcome driver of the Rick Hendrick-owned DuPont Automotive Finishes Chevrolet from Pittsboro, Indiana, the four-time and 2001 NASCAR Winston Cup Series champion, Jeff Gordon.
For our team, this championship meant so much this year. A year where the 24 car got its fourth title, NASCAR saw newer and bigger audiences, Rick Hendrick got his 100th win, and Robbie Loomis won his first championship. It was a pretty amazing year and really proved what a strong team we have. But while it was a great year for us and our team, it was a very tough year for our sport and our country. For NASCAR, the year started with the huge loss of Dale. And that loss has been there all year long and will always be there. We'll never forget what he brought to the NASCAR and how he helped the sport reach new heights. He was a friend to so many, and man, what a competitor. For me personally, I learned an awful lot from him on and off the track, and I'll never forget it. We'll never forget those who were lost that day and their bravery, the New York police and fire departments. And we saw them earlier, but we're so proud to have some of them here with us tonight. Thanks, guys, for being here, and thanks for what you do for us. As I stand here tonight, I want you to know this championship is very special. They all mean a lot, and they're all different. But this one feels more like 95 when we won our first, because in both cases, nobody really expected us to win. We finished last season in ninth with 3 wins. We had new people, a new pit crew, and we're still getting used to working together. And although you always go into each new season hoping to make a run at the championship, this year, well, we were realistic. We wanted to step things up from last year, so we set a goal to win races and finish in the top 5 in points. We knew it'd be better than last year, but we didn't think we'd be as strong as we were. So for us to finish the season with 6 wins, 18 top 5s, 6 poles, and win the championship, we even surprised ourselves. Looking back over the year, I guess what means the most to me is how we work together as a team to overcome adversity. We've had a lot of challenges over the past few years, several members of our team moving on, success on the track not coming the way it had before, and the belief some people had that our team wouldn't be a threat for the championship. So we came together, we worked together to prove that we had the drive, the desire, the resources, and the components to be back on top. We rebuilt our team, putting new people in place, and convincing Robbie Loomis to join us. And I gotta give a lot of credit to this crew. This season, they came together. They believed in themselves and grew into the strongest unit I've ever been a part of. You guys are so awesome. So awesome, man. I love you guys. Awesome. Truly was a team effort this year. I can't tell you how much that means to me. We've all matured as individuals and as a team. We knew how to step it up, and we did. And because of that, we developed a stronger bond between us, which helped us realize what might be possible. Las Vegas was our first sign that something pretty special was going on. It's a difficult track. We struggled there last year, and we started deep in the field. We worked our way to the front, and eventually we won the race. I think that race showed us right then that this could be our year. And of course, we had to back that up with some other solid finishes, but the way we worked together and performed that day was unbelievable. I know it took my confidence to a new level, and I think it did for the team, too. From that point on, we felt that kind of confidence for the rest of the season. Las Vegas showed us what was possible, and our team made the rest of it happen. We have such a great team, a smart team. Of course, that includes the engine department. Randy, Diane, thank you so much for all you do. All your folks there at Hendrick Motorsports in the engine department. Of course, Champ, congratulations on Engine Builder of the Year. Engines were awesome all year. Thanks to all the guys in the chassis and R&D areas. And thanks especially to everyone who makes up the 24 team. And also my teammates from the 25 and 5 teams, you guys play a big role, and we appreciate everything. We capitalized on our opportunities and built on our strengths. And this season, our strength of experience actually worked for us. As I said, we had a lot of new members this year, but as we battled for the championship, the veteran members of the 24 team helped guide our new guys through the highs and lows of the season. Going through 3 other championships meant that we'd been there before. It's a long season, and it's how you get through the peaks and valleys that determines who comes out on top. Robbie Loomis. What can I say? He's just such a good guy. He's likable, and I don't know anybody that doesn't like him. And I understand a little bit more now tonight why Ricky Rudd and his crew chief like you so much. We'll talk about that later. Mike McSwain, he's sharp, he's knowledgeable, ethical, and available, right? Little inside joke there, sorry, Rock. to me, he's what a champion is absolutely made of. I've really enjoyed our relationship as it's grown. For us to click early, only in our 2nd year, says a lot. This was the first time he battled for a championship, but you would have never known it. His calmness was reflected in the rest of us and helped our team always see the big picture. Congratulations,
buddy, or I should say champ, right? I also want to thank Brian Weitzel, our team manager. This guy is very important. His relationship with Robbie and our entire team, not to mention his talents and skills, are key to making it all work. My faith in God has always been a big part of my life, and I felt his presence this year even more so than in the past. I'm truly blessed in both my life and my career to live and work with the people that I do. Now, I know that Andy already mentioned the sign that we have up in our shop about teamwork being the fuel that allows common people to achieve uncommon results. But really, truly, for me, that says it all about this year and this team. What I've seen this year is the power of what can happen when people believe in themselves and support one another. And I've seen firsthand that when a team sets its mind to a goal and works together, any obstacle can be overcome and any dream can become a reality. Now, the Daytona 500 is just 79 days away. I should say 79 days are long, long ways away. But you know what? With this team right here, I wish it was tomorrow, guys. Wish it was tomorrow. Can't wait to get to Daytona. Thank you. Good night. God bless you.
Jeff, settle back into your chair right there. We've got one final thing to show you. That chair that you had to wait for earlier, you can get it now. And take a look at this video presentation. Listen to the words real careful.
He was just a boy when he took to the track. Set his sight on a dream and never looked back. Even then, a champion coming in first place. It almost seems Jeff Gordon was born to race. Twenty years later, he's still at the wheel, with a heart full of passion and nerves like steel. Set a lot of records all along the way. And if a track could talk, you'd hear it say, there goes Jeff in number 24. Out in front with the pedal to the floor. Home in NASCAR Winston Cup again. Going for the Winston Cup is a long, hard quest. If you win it more than once, you're the best of the best. When you win four times, that's a NASCAR dream. One he's proud to share with the rest of the team. There goes Jeff in number 24. Out in front with the pedal to the floor. Rolling down the straightaway, flying like the wind. Taking home the NASCAR Winston Cup again. Season's over, it's been a great year. Jeff, your fans are still waiting, hoping they're gonna hear. Yeah, there goes Jeff in number 24. Out in front with the pedal to the floor. NASCAR Winston Cup again.
Ladies and gentlemen, for a final bow, our champion, Jeff Gordon.